Arvidsson, followed up by Arvidsson. Arvidsson spins and fires one up. All right, hello everybody. Want to go over some of the board stuff with you and give you a little bit better understanding of what to look for, what to do, and kind of how to handle pucks along the boards. If you watch a hockey game, notice how often the pucks are either on the boards, along the boards, or coming off the boards, and you'll realize how important this skill really is. As we go over it, you'll kind of see some video visual examples of things and explanations, and if there's any questions at the end of it all, please feel free to reach out to me by my email or through my website, or give me a call too if you have that. So let's get going here. What you'll see is a guy entering the zone and using his body to protect the puck from the guy that's attacking him. And so he gets his body in the way, in between the puck and the player. You'll also see that he's in a strong hockey position with his knees bent. He's created some separation from the boards there in that red area. You can see he's not sitting along the boards. He's actually off the boards. His hands are out in front of him here. And you can see the stick angle compared to the boards and how he's picking it up. What he does is he uses his body, grabs a puck, makes a nice little nifty move here, and is able to get a shot off. In this example, obviously they don't score, but if you watch how often the puck goes off the boards, it's a good example of what's happening. By looking at Kopitar here, he turns his head so he sees what's coming, who's coming. He knows that puck's along the boards already, so there's no reason to follow along that puck right now. He's going to be able to pick it up again here. He moves the puck along the boards. You can see he's tight, so he hasn't given himself much room, but you can see this guy's looking for the puck, looking around him to see what's available and what's coming. And then he uses his body again between the puck and the defender. He's in a strong hockey position with the knees bent. A little bit of space on the boards, not as much as we saw in the last clip. His hands are out ahead of him, and you can kind of see how the puck is, his stick is cupping the puck and picking it up off the boards. As we follow along here, again, you'll see the player shoulder checking. Hands are out in front of him. And gives them an opportunity to attack the net. Puck goes through again off the boards. And it goes back down in the zone along the boards. Again off the boards there. And you can see how Kopitar picks it up. He's using his body. The hands are out in front of him. He's giving himself space along the boards. Right? His leg is out right now. So you can see how he's protecting that puck from the defenseman right there. And with his leg out, he's blocking that stick. And he's giving himself room along the boards there to be able to do something. He's not right up against the boards. Same thing here with Iafallo. Again, off the boards. Like I said, it doesn't result in a goal, but it's good puck possession. Good example here of what happens when you are tight against the boards. You'll see here as the puck gets rimmed along the boards, you can see how tight this player is along the boards, right? His skates, the puck is right along his skates, and he hasn't given himself much room to be able to kind of cushion himself if somebody's coming or give himself an escape at all. As you can see, he kind of ends up just trying to protect the puck along the boards. Good example here again. So you watch the defenseman here do a shoulder check, right? There's one. He actually looks again, and you can see even in the NHL, when they look, even when he looks twice and has an idea where he's going with the puck, you can see the forechecker notices this and he gets in position for it, blocks it off, and watch what they do. They get off the boards and give themselves room along the boards there in order to cushion themselves. Again, you look at the cushion, watch right here as he gets pushed, right? He's got that room along the boards right here. He gets pushed. And he's still got room to do something with it. You can see he's off the boards here. Uses the wall actually with his hand. And look who comes out with the puck. It's just good puck possession down low. Thanks for joining me. Just some little things. If you want to learn some more stuff, we have I have a lot more videos on my Hockey IQ on all these. Twitter, Instagram, LinkedIn, Facebook, YouTube. And anybody that's looking for any more personal attention for the game, I also do the same things. Doing video review with guys and voicing over them and send them back to you. And, you know, if you guys are interested in that or if anybody's interested, please feel free to reach out to me. And I'd love to use your own game tape and go over it, and I can send it back to you with ways to help improve your game. Here's some examples of what I've done with some past people, you know, giving them an idea of their options. You can see here, again, where the rebound would be, shooting angles and options. All this stuff can be found on my website. Any questions, please feel free to reach out. Again, thanks for coming, and we'll see you next time.